So today we are going to discuss about neuromyelitis optica spectrum disorder. So what is neuromyelitis optica? It is an aggressive inflammatory disorder characterized by recurrent attacks of optic neuritis and myelitis. As the name implies, or neuritis, neuromyelitis optica. So optic neuritis and myelitis. Okay. So the more inclusive term NMOSD has been proposed to incorporate individuals with partial forms and those with involvement of additional structures in the central nervous systems. Okay, and now we are going to discuss on diagnostic criteria for NMOSD. So there are two different diagnostic criteria. One is for IgG aquaphor positive status, and one another is for aquaporin negative IgG aquaphor negative status. So if a patient is positive for IgG aq4, then among these six core clinical characteristics, if any one of the following is present and if you exclude other alternate diagnosis, then you meet the diagnostic criteria for neuromyelitis optica spectrum disorder. So any one of the following, and if patient is positive for IgG aq4 with antibody and you exclude other alternate diagnosis. Okay, so this is most important. You have to exclude alternate diagnosis before telling that it is neuromyelitis optica spectrum disorder. So if it is negative for this antibody, or if you don't know the status, the antibody test is not done, in that case there should be at least two core clinical characteristics, at least two among these six, okay, occurring as a result of one or more clinical attacks and meeting all of the following requirements. So these three requirements should be met. That clinical attack, at least one core clinical characteristics must be optic neuritis, acute myelitis with longitudinally extensive transverse myelitis, or area posterior syndrome. So among these two core clinical characteristics, one core clinical characteristics must be optic neuritis, acute myelitis with longitudinally extensive transverse myelitis. So what is the definition of longitudinally extensive transverse myelitis? It means at least involvement of at least three vertebral segments or more, or area posterior syndrome. So among these three, there should be at least one, and among the rest three, there should be one. So total two core clinical characteristics, and there should be dissemination in space. So space means there should be two different locations of central nervous system that should be involved. So it will manifest with two or more different clinical characteristics and fulfillment of additional MRI requirement as applicable. So what is that meaning of this fulfillment of additional MRI requirement? So what do we see in MRI in these conditions? Here I have mentioned this for optic neuritis. What you see in MRI, brain requires brain MRI showing normal findings or only non-specific white matter lesions, or optic nerve MRI with T2 hyperintense lesion of T1 weighted gadolinium enhancing lesion extending over greater than half optic nerve length or involving optic chiasm. So for optic neuritis, this criteria for MRI should be met. For acute myelitis, there should be three or more contiguous segments should be involved. For area posterior syndrome, it requires associated dorsal medullary or area posterior region. And for acute brainstem syndrome, it requires periependymal brainstem lesion. Okay. So and obviously negative test for IgG aq4 and exclusion of alternate diagnosis. So I have mentioned it here, six core clinical characteristics. So one is optic neuritis, two is optic acute myelitis, three is area posterior syndrome. So what is area posterior syndrome? Episode of otherwise unexplained hiccups or nausea or vomiting, acute brainstem syndrome. Fifth is symptomatic narcolepsy or acute diencephalic syndrome with NMOSD typical diencephalic MRI lesions, and symptomatic cerebral syndrome with NMOSD typical brain lesions. So these are six core clinical characteristics